the skyline of Doha, Qatar, a city of some 1.3 million people, where the men's all-around final takes place today inside the Aspire Zone. The five-time U.S. champ, Sam Mikulic, looking for an individual medal for the first time at the World Championships, taking on one of Russia's finest, though, Nikita Nagorny, who has been so good so far. Zhao Rutong, the 22-year-old from China, who is the reigning world all-around champion. NBC Sports presents the World Gymnastics Championships, the 48th edition, taking place for the first time in Doha, and the men's all-around final. On the table today, Terry Gannon, along with the Olympic champs, Tim Daggett and Nastia Lukin. Top names, all competing after qualifying, and certainly Zhao Rutong, one of the first that you would talk about, the man who won the all-around title last year in Montreal, Tim.
Yeah, and he has the ability to be just phenomenal. Super powerful, can do very intricate tumbling runs like this, was the number one qualifier into the all-around finals, and of course a main member of that Chinese team. The team championships occurred just yesterday. All of this is really good. Remember, this is the first event Team China started on, and usually, if you've got a fall, it is really bad in three up, three count, and right off the bat, China goes down.
And again, right here, just so many times, shocking falls, really, from Team China right there on a skill called a Lukin.
Really difficult, full twisting laid out to Kachev, and just misjudges where he puts that left hand down.
And you know, I think when this happened, we all kind of thought perhaps maybe they had given that title away, and it came down till the very, very end.
But it started for Russia on floor with Nikita Nagorny obviously going out of bounds, but that's a triple back, incredible. And watch how great Nikita can be. Bam. He is an unbelievable talent with huge power and ginormous skills. Man, he is something else, but the last event was high bar.
And he thought he had it. He went up as the final competitor for Team Russia. You know, you never know what exactly you need going into that final event, that final routine.
But he needed a stick at the end.
And he got it.
He delivered, and it was so close. We didn't know how it would fall, but Team Russia falls to second, less than 5/100ths of a point.
So Sam Mikulic and the U.S. came in fourth in that team final. What about the effort in the team event?
Well, this is really where he had a major mistake, of course, on the pommel horse, going to try to not repeat it, but this is where he was absolutely fantastic. These are the kind of performances that we all are hoping for. You know, he's been so dominant on U.S. soil, and that's what he has told us over and over again. He doesn't need any more success in the U.S. He wants success on the world and Olympic level.
And for a long time, he has been capable. But just when we get to events like the all-around final, the Olympic final on floor, where he has the ability to win those medals and be tremendous, he has faltered. But that was unreal. He won high bar in the men's team competition yesterday.
Of course, no medals were awarded there, but had the top score.
These top names will be grouped together, too, the top seeds. The one person they don't have to worry about, the king, Kohei Uchimura, who's not in the all-around final.
No, he's not. He won six in a row world all-around titles and sprinkled in between them two Olympic titles. So 8 years in a row, and that's why they call him the king. He's not competing here. Recently, he had an injury to his right ankle. You can see him walking a little gingerly, wanted to compete in the all-around, but just wasn't quite ready.
So here are the names from the qualification and the top ones there, the top seeds. Rutong, Nagorny, Mikulic, so Sam qualifies third. Dalaloyan from Russia, Sun Wei from China, Kenzo Shirai from Japan. We'll be all together. And Yul Moldauer qualified 19th, the NCAA all-around champ from the University of Oklahoma. So, just about set for the men's all-around final.
good sign. Tim got a ginormous in the very first segment, so we're off to a good start. And on floor, that's where the top seeds will begin. Sam Mikulić among them, and we'll see if he can get his first individual medal at an international event. The world or Olympic individual medals for Mikulić with all the success on the national level. Qualification done, team finals done, and now time for the men's all-around finals. Some of the names involved there in that same group. Yul Moldauer, by the way, going to start on rings, and the top group, the top seeded gymnast starting on floor. Take me inside the mind of a Sam Mikulić right now, because from the outside, there's a lot of pressure on it. He's always asked the question, when is that international individual medal going to happen? What do you think he's feeling and thinking?
Well, you know, we've talked about this now for years. He is absolutely capable, and I think that's probably the most frustrating thing going into a competition, especially in the qualifying round. As we saw, he qualified in third place. Of course, the scores will be completely swiped clean, everybody starting from a zero. But look at this. At the 2013 Worlds, sixth finish, then a 12th, then a 7th. But almost every single time qualifying into the all-around finals, he's been in medal contention.
Well, in that first World Championships in 2013, going into the last event, he was certain to win a medal in the all-around if he had just gotten through a clean high bar routine. He did not, and he fell off the podium, and that has been his story.
That is what a lot of gymnasts or athletes in any sport can say. You look back and say, if not for this one thing, I could have. And obviously he'd like to no longer be asked these questions.
Oh, for sure. And I think, you know, after every single one of those competitions, it becomes more and more of a mental challenge and a mental game. But so far, you know, of course, he had that fall in the pommel horse in the team finals, which we showed earlier. But he has, for me, I think, looked better than he ever really has at a World Championships. We saw him at the National Championships just a few months ago, and he was rock solid there, being able to deliver, you know, more than just one time, one competition.
No, absolutely. And the one thing I find interesting, though, the top three seeds, Rutang, Nagorny, and Mikulić, they all had errors 2 days ago in the team finals. They all fell. And so,
This part of you think, if you're Sam Mikulić, all right, I got that out of the way. It happened 2 days ago. In a weird kind of way, does it take any pressure off?
I think it takes a lot of pressure off because where it happened. It happened on pommel horse, and that, in my opinion, is really the trickiest thing. And he's just got to get through his first element, his first major element, where he goes up to a handstand, comes down, back into circles again. He went up too aggressively in the team championships, and he faltered. I did say that Nikita Nagorny had a major error, and he didn't really. He just had some issues throughout the competition. Nobody was as good as they were in day one of the qualifying.
So just about set to get this underway, the men's all-around final, and those top seeds starting floor exercise. And the 23-year-old from China, Sun Wei, will be up first, qualified fifth. 84 and change, the number from the qualifying.
And for Team China, they've got a lot to live up to. As we've said, Zhao Rutang, he was the all-around champion last year, but his teammate, Lin Xiaopeng, was second. That third position went to Kenzo Shirai, who was also in this first grouping. But I tell you, this guy has long been a fan favorite because of his gorgeous look, just beautiful knees, toes, great body line. A couple of little hops and then another step. So I counted four little adjustments right there. And believe me, Penn is going to paper for those judges. Sun is a great gymnast, but the rub on him, you see him look over there. You have to finish your exercise.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone look that long.
Well, and that he's going to get a deduction for that. You have to finish by 70 seconds. He wanted to see how long he had, but that
He was definitely a little bit tired, wanted to take as long as he could, but that was a little bizarre. I've never seen someone quite look at the clock for that long. We all do a little glance every once in a while.
Exactly.
I'm guilty of that whole theme, but
absolutely.
But beautiful, his first tumbling pass, a double pike. So what makes that more difficult than what normally people do, a double tuck, is those straight knees.
Little bit off on that landing. You know, he's tremendous. There's no question about it. The rub on him is that he also comes with, historically, a lot of inconsistencies. This is the end, just a little bit short, but he takes one large step and then a small step. I would say that's about a point lower than he's capable of getting. That's what I believe he'll score.
You said something earlier, want to pick your brain on. You didn't expect any of the top seeds to go clean throughout this event today.
Yeah, just from what I have seen from all of these guys, and Sun Wei, he's great, but I don't consider him one of the very top guys. It's, you know, it's Sam Mikulec, it's Zhao Rutong, and it's Nikita Nagorny. They do such difficult gymnastics, it's often really hard to go 6 for 6.
Yeah, 13-6-3-3, that opening number for Sun Wei from China. Oleg Vernayev getting set. Man from Ukraine over near rings.
What a career he has had. Just been an amazing athlete throughout the years. Finally got an Olympic gold medal in Rio on the parallel bars. He was really shooting for the gold in the all-around, and he had a close battle with King Kohei Uchimura. Finished just infinitesimally small amount away from that title, and had to settle for silver. Later got the gold on parallel bars, as
I said. We've talked about this, and I have said this over and over, but fourth place is so hard. But when you're that close to winning an Olympic all-around gold medal, that's a tough one to swallow.
Taking the pictures of the world feed and the world broadcaster, so we don't have control of the pictures. Yul Moldauer already went on rings. 13-4-6-6, the number for Yul.
And you see the shoulder right there, taped up. Oleg has had a number of surgeries, his shoulder being one of them. The most difficult events for him are high bar and this one right here. He didn't even train on the competition floor on the steel rings during the podium training. Starts off well. I'll tell you what, when you've got shoulder issues, these strength parts, and he's going to get a deduction for that, are just really, really hard. Once again, he is a little bit high on that cross position. Each one of these strength parts, you have to be definitive. 2 full seconds. I think that one was fine. I'll tell you what, for having shoulder surgery, that was pretty darn good for Oleg Vernayev.
Three-time world medalist, but all on parallel bars. Vernayev, the veteran, who's 25 now, lives in Kiev.
And one of the, not that you get, you know, points for being nice, but just one of the nicest, most respectful competitors out there. As you said, he's been around, even though only not so old, but he's been around for many years.
You should, though. Half a point.
I agree.
Yeah.
So there's the problem. He had 2 crosses in his routine. His arms are completely out to the side. I would say both of them are about 3/10 off. If I'm being nitpicky, his elbows were a little bent on that.
But, you know, he knows he's not quite ready to contend for an all-around medal. Trying to recover from all the injuries. Of course, Tokyo 2020 coming up, and that's where he'll want to be more or less at his best.
Got to be frustrating, though, as an athlete, top-level athlete.
Of course.
So we go over to floor, and we are set for Sam Mikulec, the 26-year-old. He's out in Colorado Springs now, qualified third for this all-around 5-time U.S. champ, trying to get it done on the international level.
And I'll tell you what, this is a risky routine for him, mostly because of his first pass, a combination tumbling pass that'll finish with a double flip really hard to time all of this. Let's see what Sam we have today. That's a good one. Great start for Sam on one of his trickiest pieces of gymnastics that he'll have to accomplish all day long. Truly a just a gorgeous gymnast aesthetically, but also has the difficulty to contend with the very top in the world. He is doing a great job thus far. Nice landings. Nice easy double twist right here for him. He does a triple fold for the end. Actually incurred a really serious Achilles tear on this about a year ago. Pretty darn good, Sam Mikulak. A great start.
One down, five to go.
Most recent injury, a back injury, but 100% he says now. And he also said, look, I got a better outlook at the World Championships this time around. I've got outlets. I'm not putting pressure on myself the way I used to. I am much more comfortable.
Really nice tumbling runs. Little bit of an adjustment. And yes, the judges will take a deduction for that. But this was the critical area right there. Two and a half twists to a double front, and he rocks the house on the landing.
Of course, Team USA finished fourth place in the team finals, just outside the medals, but he said the expectations for us weren't very high going into it. People didn't see us on the podium, but I think we showed that we're a lot closer to being on that podium than people expected.
Yeah, he was revved up about that performance. He was tweeting about it and saying, look, dude, they notice us now. They know we're here, and we're putting pressure on them. Vernaya 14.066 for the effort on the still rings. Back in a moment. First effort from Sam Mikulak, 14.4, the number, as we watch Nikita Nagorny now, one of the favorites from Russia.
Oh, my God, I just love it. Triple back, and now, similar to Sam, double full to double front, and yikes, that was tremendous. Got his start in gymnastics. His grandmother said he was getting into too much trouble. He needed an outlet. Love the way he does that. Adds that third acrobatic element at the end of that tumbling run. And this is crazy. He could do something so much easier down a side pass, but he does a full twisting double. Most people aren't even doing double somersaults or just doing a double twist. Just has the dismount remaining. He'll also do that triple full we just saw from Sam Mikulak. Oh my, wow. Wow.
Been on the scene a number of years, even though he just is 21. He was the youngest member of that Russian team that won the silver medal in Rio at the Olympics. So there's the number officially, 14.4 for Sam.
Which is a very strong start for him. I'll tell you what, though, as you mentioned, Terry, if someone can go error-free throughout this competition, then they are sitting in a very good position. When you see the level of difficulty, I mean, Nagorny's floor exercise is just off the charts difficult. He handled it perfectly.
So pommel horse we go. The 21-year-old from Chiba, Japan, Kazuma Kaya, just about ready. Qualified 10th. With this all around, helped Japan to its first world team title in 37 years at the 2015 Worlds.
And boy, was that something. And they had been craving that for so long. The Worlds prior to that, it looked like it was going to happen, and it didn't. But 2015 was a joyful time for Team Japan.
And a bronze medal this time around, as the U.S. came in fourth.
is actually very good on pommel horse. It's interesting. That was, you know, when you salute the judge, basically you're supposed to start right away. That was a little bit too long of a pause for me, but I'm sure. No, I don't think so. This one pommel work, very, very tricky. You see how intricate the hand placements are. Good rhythm overall. Not brushing the horse, which is really critical. A lot of gymnasts, they kind of just brush the horse, fly up to the handstand, and that was stellar for this young man. They're going it without the king, King Kohei. But they have a tremendous gymnast here, and Kenzo Shirai is the other Japanese competing.
Agornia, the number 14.733. So you remember Sam McCulloch's score, 14.4.
Yeah, I don't get that score, to be perfectly honest. The landings were spectacular. I think it was too low, the execution score.
Xiaoru Tong, another one of the top names ready in the reigning all-around world champion.
But remember, in the team final, he faltered on this event. That was okay. He's done that better since he's been here.
Looked a little rotated.
Got to do a double flipping skill in gymnastics right now. This is his double layout. And this is where he fell in the team championships. This is a layout with 2.5 twists. And once again, did not have a complete fall, but did a lot of hopping around there.
In team finals, he over-rotated the skill, perhaps this time trying to go the opposite and under-rotate it a little bit.
That's not disastrous, though. Once again, you see, there's the difference. That's the side pass I was talking about. He did a double full. Nikita did a full twisting double back. Also the triple full here. Oh, and a great way to finish. That's like an exclamation mark.
Tim, we're just waiting for your line.
Gymnastics 101, fly high and stick the landing. There it is for you, Nastia. And, you know, I really think that that ending will help. Last thing the judges see. Double laid out. Just a small hop. If you take a step or a hop, but this is where the problem is, and that was very under. And look at his chest, how low it is to the ground. That is also a deduction in addition to the stepping around. Each step is either a tenth or 3/10 of a point.
So a little more than 3/10 of a point between Nagorny and McCulloch. We'll get the number on Zhao in a moment, but over to Andre Muntan from Romania on vault.
That 5.2, that is his starting score, and beautiful, clean vault. You add the 10 points in execution, so his max is a 15.2. Very nicely done. Just not only a 1/10 hop, because it is less than shoulder width apart.
Went to the World Championships last year, but didn't qualify for the event finals. Kazuma Kaya, 14.1.
I don't know. The all week long so far, the execution scoring and judging has just seemed a little tough.
Yeah, it used to be that the really great athletes were losing about a point, and now the really great athletes are losing close to 1.8, and it's too harsh.
You're lucky if you get in the mid-8s.
So over to floor, last man to go. Olympic medalist Kenzo Shirai, 22-year-old, reigning world champion on floor.
He's capable of doing a triple twisting double layout. Don't think he's going to do that today, but he does a triple twisting double back in the tuck position. And That pass may not have looked difficult, but he finished with a triple full forwards. Nobody in the world can twist like this guy, hence his nickname in Japan, the Twist Prince. Quad turn on that. For a long time, Kenzo was thought to be just a floor X and vaulting specialist. And then after he'd been around a while, he started to add an event here or there. And last year was the third best all-around gymnast in the world. Oh my.
No big deal. Just at, almost at the end of your floor routine.
Yeah, I don't
know. Three and a half twist.
Maybe. Wow. And a triple pull at the end, maybe 15 or so twists in that routine, and I'm just dizzy watching it. I mean, it's so hard, but I have to tell you, the way they have been judging, he opened up the door on a lot of those landings.
Bhutan on vault 14.433. Carlos Yulo ready to go on pommel horse.
And he has been just a super fan favorite. Look at how little he is. Has to really jump to get up to the pommel horse. Nice up to the handstand, back down. This is not maybe his best event, but he's really great gymnast. He didn't feel he was getting the type of training that he needed in the Philippines. So where'd he go? He went to Japan, and it has paid off. A young man that has a very bright future in the sport.
Lives in Tokyo, trains there, and would love to be in the mix for the Olympics when they roll around. Goes to university. He's only 18 years of age, Carlos Yulo. So we'll get his number, get the number for Zhao Rutong. So it's sub 14 on floor for the reigning world all-around champ. McCulloch looking okay after one. Sam, a little more than 3/10 of a point off the effort of Nikita Nagorny in the floor exercise as we continue. So we checked the standings after the first rotation. Kenzo Shirai received a number of 14.9 for that floor exercise. Big number there. Naloyan from Russia in second. Avtian from Armenia in third. And Nagorny right there, 14.7. That surprised you a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was so difficult and it was so cleanly executed. I think that he really got robbed on that. He should be right with Kenzo at this point in time, my opinion.
And Sam McCulloch, where he is right now?
I think he's in a great spot. But, of course, that was a good start. But now on to the pommel horse, which, of course, will be a huge test, especially after the team finals.
You say that with a voice of doom.
Yeah, but he's great on horse. He right. Qualified. You know, he's in the all-around finals, and he qualified for four individual events as well, pommel horse being one of them.
So that's where that top group will go next. And this second of six rotations. Delaloyan will be up first. Sam second, Nagorny, Rutong, Shirai, and Soon Wei, who started things on floor.
You know, it's like the balance beam for the women, and I've said this before, but you could train and have, you know, amazing training sessions, be so consistent, but as soon as that green light is on, you raise your arm, you know, one finger is off, and or on beam, maybe your toe, and, yeah. And unfortunately, it's hard to save, and it's hard to fight on an event like that.
If you're Sam McCulloch and you're in that group, you are one of the top gymnasts in the world. That's just reality. But how does that affect you as you compete with the top names?
Well, it could go either way, you know. And I think he finally really believes not only that he is good enough, but that he can do it in this situation. I do believe he feels that way now. I think in the past, when he was in these big situations. I think there was a little bit of doubt always that maybe he didn't belong, which was wrong because he was good enough.
Mm-hmm. Joel Moldauer, by the way, in 16th place after that first rotation. So he's in that group that moves over to vault next.
Yeah, and he started on Still Rings, which is historically a great event for Yule, but he came here with a bicep tendon injury, and it has really slowed him down on Still Rings. He'll get better from this point on.
So Zhao Rutong, the winner of the all-around last year. You go back in history since 2003, Paul Hamm, the American, obviously, and then a run of Kohei Uchimura.
Craziness. And, you know, 2017, you got to remember that he, you know, very easily could have added another one, but midway through the competition, he suffered a very serious injury on vault, tore some ligaments in his ankle, desperately tried to continue, went to parallel bars, landed his dismount, hobbled off, and that was it for King Kohei. And it opened the door for everybody else. Finally, a lot of people were thinking.
Oleg Vernayev can start here on fault. By the way, the judges, they have changed the score for Zhao Rutong. They've up to 0.2 of a point, so it's 14.133. We had mentioned it was a sub-14 number. It's no longer that.
Yeah, and I just don't think that the execution merits that, but the only way they can change a score is they started his score too low. This is a really big vault. Handspring, double front with a half turn. Oh, my gosh. Oleg came to play.
You know, just when we said that he knows that he's probably not fighting for a medal, he's going to say, I'm going to prove you guys wrong here.
Yeah. And I'll tell you what, after this vault, and then he goes to parallel bars where he's spectacular. Look at the landing. That's a Dragulescu named after Marian Dragulescu, the great from Romania. Three times around. Does that half turn out? Is laser focused on the ground. And I tell you what, folks, that is not easy to do at all. I mean, it's just amazing to me how these gymnasts can now do that vault. When it was first being done, I remember thinking that, you know, most people are just hoping they don't die.
That's a good way to put it, Tim. 30,
to the point. 31-year-old from Germany, Marcel Neuwen, who has been to the Olympics three times, 2008, 2012, and 2016. Qualified for this all-around 24th.
Won a silver medal in the all-around at the 2012 Olympics.
Yeah, he has had a long career.
Think about mentally, but also physically, what you go through to still be competing at this level at the age of 31.
Well, if you are at 31 and you've been to as many competitions as he has, you're typically pretty beaten up, which he has been. He's doing better now. You know, I talked with him and Fabian Hambuchen prior to this competition, and, you know, one of the frustrations has been that there's nobody young coming up. And so that's why Fabian continued for so long, and Marcel is as well. This is a very good routine. A little bit messy on that skill, but it's really challenging to do. He has one of the most difficult dismounts being done in the world. Akash Mogi from the U.S. does it as well. Actually, not doing it today. He's capable of doing a full twisting double back. Went a little bit easier. Double pike somersault. Really nicely done. It's so hard to keep that skill called a makuts going. But you see that right there. He is just going to get clobbered by the judges on that because legs are apart, feet are flexed, and he does not open his body. when you do that skill, you have to show a complete opening before your arms hit.
How about this number for Vernayev, the veteran, 14.966.
And it looks to me like he's got some ice on that shoulder right now.
Okay, over to pommel horse and erase all memories from that team final if you're Sam Mikulic.
Well, you know, in my opinion, I think he needs to, hopefully he's remembering what happened, because he went up so aggressively to the handstand on the first time and he just couldn't control it. He remounted the pommel horse, did the exact same skill, and did it great and finished the entire exercise, but he went up slower, more controlled, and because of that, he was able to pull it off. So I would imagine he's thinking about that right now. Take it a little easy on that. Don't go up too fast.
Are you going through your whole routine in your head right now?
I personally, yes. I did a lot of visualizing, going through every single element from start to finish.
And Sam absolutely does that. I didn't do that as much. I just wanted to.
So what was your way to prepare?
I thought about the first element, and then from there, I just, you know, I just try. My mantra always was, as a gymnast and a coach, it's always stay exactly in the moment. Don't think a moment behind. Don't think a moment ahead.
Well, of course, yeah. Well, once I got up on the apparatus, that's what I was thinking. But before, I think just being able to kind of replay it over in your head so it becomes muscle memory, because that's truly what it is. When you're at this point, when you're competing at a world all-around finals or an Olympic Games, you are prepared. It is all mental, and we're about to see that right here.
And once you start, the last thing you want is to be in your head.
He'll do a couple of scissors and then basically ready for the skill he's capable of doing as well as anybody in the world. Right here, he'll go up to a handstand and he does it great. Now, he's just gotta make sure he doesn't get ahead in his thoughts, think, oh, that went well. One more travel across the horse. The dismount for Sam Mikulic. Wow! That is a gigantic routine for Sam.
This is not the team final. This is the all-around final. Much different routine from Mikulic this time around.
That skill right there, that scissor where he travels the entire body of the horse, it's actually a Mikulic. He invented it. He did everything right there. You know, after making that skill that he struggled on, sometimes you can see an athlete, you know, get too excited thinking, you know, got through that and then mess up a little bit, but.
Well, as you said, it's one thing at a time. Having the patience, especially on the events, which pretty much every single one where one skill comes after another, everything is connected. You cannot be ahead of yourself.
But that was big.
That was big.
And the great thing about Sam is he's got rings next, which is a walk in the park for him. Vault, where he can do it easily. It only gets a little dicey maybe on the last event where he's got a super difficult high bar routine.
Over to Vault, the 25-year-old from Switzerland, Pablo Breger.
And a nice vault. That was just a Kasamatsu with an extra full twist. So two twists around. Little bit close to that line. The line is in gymnastics, so no deduction.
That is much better than he had in qualifying and the team. 14.2. Nikita Nagorny in his final moments as Mikulic certainly satisfied or should be with that effort on Pommel.
Right at the end, All he had to do was just get up to the handstand.
14.3, what do you think?
No, it's good. That's about where I thought it would come in. You know, really, what he's going to be hoping for is for people to falter a little bit so far. Nikita Nagorny doing great, but this is a place where he's not as great. He's just not built to do horses. Arms are a little bit shorter. He's somewhat stocky, which makes it a bit challenging, but he's capable of doing really hard stuff. Was good in the qualifying, but in the team final, got a really low score for Russia. That was his challenge. Oh boy, little bit of, I would have to say that was probably nerves, to be honest. And he's opening the door a little bit with his execution. His body isn't as extended as it could be. Had that form issue midway through, but he survives, and that's good for him.
Very good start from Akulik. We'll get the number on Nagorny as we continue. Back with a 23-year-old from England, James Hall. It still rings. Competed last year at the World Championships. Did not make a final in any event.
His biggest title is 2017 European Championships. He was third in the all-around. And he's told me it's all well and good to be steady and the average guy all the time, but I want to be up there with the world's best, and that means that I got to take some risks. And he is right about that. Nice iron cross position. Very nice. Great rhythm on that swing combination. Good control.
Big smile. From the teeth in the morning, big sigh of relief.
Dismount double, double. Oh, and boy, I thought he had that landing. He's got very nice form, good execution. Looking for that ground. He sees it now, puts his feet down, and oh, just takes the slightest little step. I thought I could have held on that one.
14-1 in qualifying and the team event for James Hall. So we'll see what the judges think of that here in the all-around final.
Should be right around in that area again.
All right, so that top-seeded group, we saw Sam Akulik, Nagorny before those two on pommel horse, Artur Dalaloyan, also one of the top names here.
Absolutely, and really, for him, getting through pommel horse is a gigantic deal. It is not one of his strong points.
Next on only 11.766 in qualifying on pommel horse for Dalaloyan.
Yeah, it's not his event, that's for sure. He's a power guy. Nicely done, though. Up to that handstand. This is about as good as I have ever seen him look on horse, without question. Wow, I'll tell you what, not gonna bring in that, you know, 14 plus score, but an excellent effort for him, and that is a huge sigh of relief. Nice flare work. Could have his hips a little more extended. You see how close to the pommel they are. The judges are looking for a little bit more distance, but as I said, a really good job for him.
Whole lot better than qualifying.
And you know, the whole entire group, this top group so far, not trying to jinx anyone here, but so far the top group has had a great rotation on the pommel horse.
Yeah. And no major mistakes anywhere there, really. So there is the number once again. And total 28.2 so far through a couple of rotations.
Yeah, but he should definitely rally back. That score is going to hurt him, but not as badly as it could have.
Berhad Arıcan, 25-year-old from Turkey, ready on parallel bars. Competing in his 7th world championship.
Starting with a whippet skill, very popular nowadays. Big skill. This is so challenging to do this skill right onto one bar, freeze it, and be stable enough to do that full spin down. Handles that well. But just little form, you know, that was a basic skill. And his legs came apart a little bit. Really capitalizes on, once again, you see nice skill Diamandov, but legs came apart. Great dismount, though. Really strong routine, but he just opens the door a bunch.
20th in the all-around last year at the World Championships and on parallel bars, came in 8th.
Well, he does this skill where he goes to his upper arms and then he swings his body forward, spins on one arm. It's a front uprise Diamandov. It's right here, and it's very hard, but certainly a little bit shy of the handstand and a little bit of form as well. Once again, you see those legs flicker apart. Great dismount, though.
See him eyeing the ground. Perfect. Happy with that one. 18-year-old Carlos
Edmo James Hall, 14.066.
Yeah, right around where he has been both days of competition so far.
Now, over to vault, and the 22-year-old, Yul Moldar, ready.
And I have said this before, that he has an uncanny ability to stick this vault. Let's see. Oh, not quite today. Really nice, though. It's so clean.
And that's really what he is known for, his form on every single event, every single skill. Last year at the World Championships, he's happy with that one.
What do you think, 14-4?
No, pretty good, pretty good. And he's got a great event, parallel bars, coming up next.
But at the World Championships last year, really impressed so many by the form that he had on every single event. It was his, of course, first World Championships.
And he came away with a bronze medal on floor, and he did it with execution. Everybody else had harder routines than him.
14-6, Berhad Arıcan. Over to Still Rings and the 21-year-old from Great Britain, Bryn Bevan.
And you see that right there, those Roman numerals on his chest. He got a tattoo the day his father passed from cancer, and on his deathbed, he made a promise, I'd go to the Olympics, do my best to come home with a medal. Those Roman numerals are the day his father passed away. And then he went to Rio, and you can only see a little bit of it, but his entire back is Christ Redeemer. So.
Came in 4th in Rio, but team did. He was part of that.
But actually, he was the alternate for this competition for Great Britain. Niall Wilson, who was one of the veterans of that team, injured his finger, you know, immediately prior to traveling to Doha, and he was the traveling alternate. He got named and ended up making the all-around finals.
Bevan, the reigning British all-around champ.
He has also had his share of injuries. Beaten up a little bit. Improved this position quite a lot. Picked up a little bit of swing on that, kind of bailed at the wrong time a bit. And he's very good on rings, but doesn't have the massive difficulty that we've seen from some of the other athletes. Just doesn't have the strength quite yet to pull that off.
This competes rotation two. Gentlemen, please. 13.6 in the qualifying for Bevan. So rotation two at its end here in the men's all around. And so far, keeping track, Yoel Moldauer, you saw that 14 plus on the vault a moment ago, and Sam McCulloch, very good on the pommel horse. He got through that. We'll get a number on Bevan as we continue and get you the overall standings here.
If you think these strength moves aren't hard, you look at Brent and he's like shaking. He is pushing and struggling as hard as he can. Double twisting, double somersault.
Makita Nagorny, we saw that routine 13.566 on pommel horse. So 28.299 the total so far through a couple of rotations. And the all-around final taking place for the first time in Doha. Cutter. Some problems in the team event for Sam McCulloch on pommel horse, but not in the all-around. Excellent. Is he on his way to a medal at the World Championships? Stick around and find out. Back to check the standings after rotation number two. Muntan 29.083. So the leader, surprised with Vernayev. In second right now, certainly capable, but didn't have great expectations coming into the all-around.
No, I didn't, especially because he started on rings, but he struggled through and then just was spectacular on vault. And Andre from Romania, obviously, he benefited from vaulting as well.
Now, Sam McCulloch, you saw where Sam was in fourth right now, so moves up a couple, and Yoel Moldauer currently in 13th place.
Which is okay, you know, really I don't think he anticipates having, you know, a spectacular run here, as I mentioned. He has that bicep problem that has really hindered him about a point on the still rings alone.
So we move to rotation three of the six in that top group. The top seeds move over to still rings. And Sam McCulloch got to be feeling pretty good after the effort in the first two.
Absolutely, and he has really, really big events at the end of the competition. His parallel bars and high bar are huge assets for him, going to still rings now and then vault after that.
You know, and that's exactly what he said. He said that this is the most comfortable that I have ever been on this grand of a stage. Little slow-mo action here.
From the warm-ups, I believe.
Yep.
But nicely done.
Or so we think, right?
Yeah, not quite sure.
Sometimes we don't quite know what to expect with the world feed, but With Sam, you know, we can just keep going over and over about this, but he really has been so excellent on U.S. soil. And Tim, I think you'd have to agree, this really is the best and most confident and comfortable that he has looked at a World Championships.
Absolutely, without question.
And you can listen and say, wow, you keep hammering that home. But the fact is, he talks about it. When we talked to him at the U.S. Championships, he said, and this was before he won his fifth title, he said, this is great, but I am so focused on doing something internationally. That is what I'm all about now. I got to get that done.
You know, one of the things that he has said over and over again, though, is in the past, he has lived, breathed 100% gymnastics, total focus,
yep.
Nothing else, nutrition, everything, rest, recuperation. And he says, I've chilled out now. He's got his own home, lives with his girlfriend, got a puppy, which has really...
Puppies can change everything.
They can, I'm telling
you.
The start on parallel bars, and Lucas Dowser, the 25-year-old from Germany.
Really nice underbar work. And beautiful. That's so difficult. Does two of those elements, very high bonus points for those. Oh, boy. And we've seen a couple of gymnasts do that skill and make it look effortless, but I'll tell you, it is not really tricky. And then another huge error. Swing back and forth. Every time you do a swing without doing an element, there are big deductions. And this just got started great, but ended. Not good at all.
Trying to come back from injury, torn ACL, meniscus in his right knee last summer after falling in a competition. Two surgeries for that.
I'll tell you, the start was fantastic. Right here, though, he just fumbles his hand. Mm. And that right there is probably close to a point off in deductions.
James Hall.
And by the way, Sam Mikulik started things on rings for that group. 14-1-6-6 for Sam.
Respectable, certainly.
Kazuma Kaya now on vault.
His difficulty maximum score, 15.2, 2.5 twists, same vault. We saw from Yul Moldauer, basically about the same. Overall, he's pretty clean in the air. A 1/10 hop, I would say. Watch his legs from the board to the table. And yeah, his legs come apart significantly more than we saw from Yule. It's very hard to do that. Get a better angle here. And those judges, they are keying in on that because it is a very common error. And that was 3/10 apart.
In real time, you would hope they don't miss much, but you're bound to miss something, right, as a judge?
Little bit, but you know what? So many gymnasts make that error that sometimes, even if you do it well, they take it because they just assume that you did straddle your legs a bit.
Well, and they're watching all of the trainings as well, the podium trainings, the qualifications, so they almost know what to expect from every athlete.
Still ranks Nikita Nagorny of Russia. Just a few moments ago after Mikulik went.
Really gotten much stronger with his strength position. Very challenging start. And you see he arrives at that position. He doesn't come in a little bit high and lower down, which is exactly what the judges want to see. That one not as perfect. He landed a little high and lower down, a tenth maybe for that. But the routines that they have to do on still rings nowadays, exhausting. And they get to the end and they still gotta flip twice and twist twice and wow. For Nikita Nagorny, he is really looking excellent today.
Dowser 12-4-3-3 on parallel bars.
You know, if you have a routine like that and you're always like, just don't look, don't look.
Yeah.
You don't want to see it, but you always look.
You gotta look.
You always look.
Parallel bars keep it here, and Pablo Breger from Switzerland will be next to go. Pretty impressive what we just saw from Nagorny, right?
Absolutely. You know, he used to be, you know, in competitions just a little too lighthearted maybe, and kind of not in the zone to the degree that he needed to be. He has not been like that here in Doha at all. You see on that skill, he clipped his leg. Significant deduction for that. And right there, that they might take away the entire skill and give him a stop. You have to be fluid on that. Keep it moving right on up to the handstand. Couple of steps, three steps. When you move your hands on parallel bars, each time it's a tenth of a point. Oh boy, yeah. Whew.
Ouch.
Yeah, saw that coming. That front uprise just was, I don't know if he fumbled his grip at the end. But didn't have the extension he needed at the end of that to get a good swing.
This should be behind it is 14.5 for Nikita Nagorny from Russia.
Very big number for him. If you were worried looking at some of these athletes that had dropped down the list after Pommelhorst, don't be. He will rocket back up the standings here and then go to vault and separate himself even more.
Zhao Rutong underway.
Got to hold each strength part for 2 seconds, and that second one was not. Really tricky to do that combination and get away with it, but that one better. Got to just freeze those positions. And a full 2 seconds. For the contenders, though, still rings. Double-double here. Oh, boy. Great routine, not backing down at all.
After the team competition, he said that we know we can do even better. We have to teach ourselves how to relive the pressure and how to come back, and he sure is doing that today.
He had two major falls in the team competition, the number one qualifier into the all-around finals, but so far today, 3 for 3 and looking very strong.
Also a short time ago on vault, James Hall from Great Britain. And a lot of the British athletes here today.
And you see that 5.2. Gonna do the same vault that we've seen a couple of different times here. Nicely done, you know, gonna be in that maybe 9.3 range of execution. The question is, does he step over the line on the landing? I don't think he does. No, not at all. Not even close. Not as perfect in the air, though. The legs a little bit apart and just soft, and feet very flexed.
Just didn't quite have as much amplitude. But you were close, Tim.
Yeah, he nods. He approves.
All right with that.
Breger, yeah, the problems that we just saw on parallel bars.
Yikes.
Yeah. Well, he didn't even have a dismount. If you land, if you don't land feet hitting first, then it's not even counted. So.
Still rings that top group. And Soon Wei.
Remember, China went 1-2 at the most recent World Championships. Same mount, done a little bit better, in my opinion. A lot of the Chinese, though, their cross position is a little bit high. Their arms aren't completely out to the side. I mean, it's not a big deal. That's gorgeous right there. And it's funny because it's not, once again, you see his body, his arms should be completely out to the side, and it's a little high on everyone. They should be taking deductions for that, both arriving in the position too high and then not showing the position. We've seen some tremendous landings today, and that was not one of them. Huge deduction on that dismount.
Zhao Rutong, by the way, 14-3-3-3 for his effort on rings as we continue with our coverage. Back with our coverage, parallel bars, and Oliver Hagi from Switzerland.
Just has a beautiful look when he does gymnastics. Long legs. If you can control it, it can look a little bit nicer. Big release. He's an excellent gymnast, but really shines on the next event, high bar. Nice floaty stutz to handstand, and then one to the single bar, just the dismount. Yeah, very classy routine. You know, doesn't have, you know, the monstrous start value score, maximum potential, but really nicely done. A lot of the Swiss gymnasts have that look, and it's really great to see.
Sun Wei, 13-9 for his score on ring.
And I'm glad to see that, actually. I thought they were going to be a little bit higher, but as I said, those cross positions, they're too high.
Artur Dalaloyan will be next from Russia to close out this group here on rings.
Team finals, he had a big number, 14-5, 3-3.
He's dropped a bit, so he's got to go about this time.
Same mount sequence that we saw from Nikita Nagorny. Very difficult. And like a back kip to a Maltese. And once again, you see a little bit more square, showing a more correct position. And that one, excellent. Landing right in the cross position, not settling down into it. His gymnastics from here on out, vault through high bar, are off the charts great. And I'll tell you what, he was predominantly the reason why Russia came away with silver instead of gold on parallel bars, fell off. But he has looked really good today.
Hagi 14-6-6-6, so 41 and change overall. Yul Moldauer from the U.S., ready on parallel bars. Remember, he was 13th after the second rotation.
And he does this skill, I think, better than anyone. Huge air, just like shot out of a canyon. Tricky right here, nicely done. Little bit of walking around there. Once again, a little bit over on that giant Diamandov, but 10th or so. Such a classy gymnast. I had the pleasure to watch him grow up in the sport. Wonderful person and a tremendous athlete. Capable of sticking that, though.
teammate loved it, though, watching the 2017 U.S. all-around champ. Twice the NCAA all-around champion.
Look at the height. He just floats in the air. Gorgeous work. You see him make those adjustments with his hands. Not supposed to do that. And just moments ago, we saw him rock the landing on that in the warm-ups.
I was just about to say, when he is on, he gets those landings.
Important score for Artur Dalaloyan, 14.533, because as you said, he's got a couple of events still to come that he's very good at.
Off the charts good.
Yeah. Moldauer thumbs up. You're still just 22 years old.
Going into his senior year at the University of Oklahoma.
All right, 14.5.
Yeah, he doesn't have the very highest difficulty, but you don't see often 8.6 execution nowadays. It's Reagan Smith. Looks on.
Got the women's all-around final tomorrow, where obviously Simone Biles is the favorite. Morgan Hurd, the reigning world all-around champ. Oleg Vernayev, who's had a great start to this all-around.
And it should only get better right here. Tremendous on the parallel bars. Olympic champion here. Has such a calm look on this event, and to make that look calm is nearly impossible.
Wow.
Go to the end of the bars now. Love this skill, love the way he does it. This is a boxar from one end of the bars to the other. A lot of guys are doing that now, but very few of them get the height that he does. And this is a tremendous routine. Double front half. Wow. Oh, baby.
There's your wild card, right?
I mean, he really is just trying to prove us wrong here.
Yeah, you see him grab that shoulder, though. My hope is that he's not rushing it, you know, that he's not pushing himself too hard, too quickly, because, you know, you have a major shoulder injury and then surgery. You know, if you rush it, it can spell problems down the road. But this was a great exercise. Look at how high he is. And watch how high his body is above the bars. You see that? Very cool. Looks like a stealth fighter jet.
Two-time Olympic medalist, silver medal in the all-around in 2016. But coming back off the injury, he is making a statement here so far in the all-around. Yeah. Fist pump indeed. Oleg Vernayev from Ukraine. And that is a big number. 15.666.
Wow.
And it's Vernayev who takes the lead here.
That is a gigantic number. And it always helps to come up with an exclamation mark. Stick that landing.
Through three rotations of events all around. Been interesting so far through three rotations. Oleg Vernayev, the veteran from Ukraine, in the lead. Jiaoru Tong, good little comeback here through the third rotation. Ahead of Sam Mikulic, who moves up to number three. And look at the bottom of your screen. Yul Moldauer has moved on the way up from 13th to 8th. Ahmet Ander in 5th. And take you back, take a look at this routine from that third rotation here on parallel bars.
Doing a very nice job today, and seen a lot of gymnasts here that have dealt with that one bar skill right into the Healy really well. Very nicely done. Also gets a lot of air on that release. Oh boy. And right there, definitely open the notebook for the judges to scribble on.
Still, and remember, that was back in the third rotation, the 22-year-old from Turkey with the 14.666, so able to get into the top five.
That kind of surprises me, that execution right? score, yeah. You know, I mean, it was very good, but it had a very visible error.
Top seeds, that group, over to vault now. It'll be Nikita Nagorny from Russia who will lead things off. Nagorny currently overall in fourth.
And he was off the charts on this event in the team championships. We saw Oleg Vernayev do the Dragulescu, that triple front with a half turn at the end. He does the same one. He's capable of sticking as well. This is a big one for him. You know, the irony here is I think that was the best one, technically, that he's done since he's been in Doha, but he doesn't manage the landing as well. Watch, he gets his whole body up towards the handstand position right here, doesn't rush that tuck, so gets a little bit more height than he's used to. Really challenging, but takes a hop and then I would say another 10th step, but still gonna be a huge number. One hop, one step.
But not quite like he did in the team finals just a few days ago.
Yeah, I had over 15 in that team final. Right now 14.766, which is a little bit better than he did in the qualifying.
And he knows he can stick that though.
Keep it here on vault. Xiao Rutong from China, currently in second place overall.
Also a 15.6 start value, does it totally different way. Sukahara, triple twist. Very nicely done, pretty clean. But that step right there, that's definitely a 3/10 step because it was more than shoulder width apart, I would say. Pretty good form onto the table too, and
beautiful in the air as well. You want to look at his toes, his knees, his hip position coming down right here, eyes the ground. Really just that step.
Yeah, it was. It's going to be a good number. I would say probably going to be greater than what we just saw from Nikita.
Meanwhile, Ahmet Ander, we just saw him in that third rotation, the parallel bars routine. 22-year-old rounding out the top five so far. You're on high bar.
And I'll tell you, what a position for this young man to be in. We're pretty far into the all-around in for him to be sitting in fifth place.
He was ninth last year at the World Championships in the all-around.
Release right off the bat, beautiful. Nice laid out to Kachev, another release right here.
Does it with... getting a little further on, on each one.
Well, that's what you want. You want to be far, but you also...
Well, wow. Maybe not that far, that was a little too...
You also really want to catch it. He'll do the same thing with a half turn here. Nice gymnast.
Little low on that handstand. And that one as well.
I would say 3/10 of an angle deduction on both of those. Up until that point, pretty error free. small step on the landing, but very bright future this young man has. Very bright.
His second trip to Worlds, back over to vault. Kenzo Shirai taking a last look.
And this can be absolutely spectacular. He's going to do a triple twist also, but he'll do it the Yurchenko style. He can stick this. Gorgeous in the air. Oh!
And just put like, no big deal.
I just had a feeling, you know?
Little head nod. Yep, I meant to do that.
Wow.
And needs a big number. He should get it. He's down in 15th right now.
Oh, he's going to get a big number for sure. He's very clean from the board to the table, as you can see. Great form in the air, just a slight cross landing. But don't move those feet, Kenzo.
I mean, it literally looked like he was doing a triple twist on the floor exercise.
Hmm.
Which, don't get me wrong, is difficult there too. But when you put it on the vault.
He actually has somewhat of a similar technique to the great Michaela Maroney. Reaches with his hands a little bit out on the table, gets that instantaneous block. It either works really great, like it did for Michaela and Kenzo, or it works really badly.
Rutong, 14-8-6-6. He was in second after that third rotation, so right in the mix, showing you his guns. Here's the number. Just over 15, 15-166,
wow.
Which obviously you're over 15, but you expected a huge number from that.
Yeah, I thought about a tenth higher,
yeah.
To be perfectly honest.
But come on, Tim, over a 9.5 execution?
Oh, I know.
Where else are you going to find that?
Yeah, don't yell at me now.
No, go ahead. It's kind of fun. All right, Soon Wei from China in ninth after three rotations.
Do the same vault we just saw from from Zhao Rutong. And that was gorgeous in the air. Absolutely gorgeous.
Key
phrase there, in the air.
In the air. I was just about to say, not quite as good on that landing. His chest was down.
It was.
Very low, the hop.
But wow, he has such a beautiful look while doing gymnastics. Great leg form. Look at how perfect he is in the air, but as you mentioned, the chest down. I mean, it is really hard to point your toes on that element. A little shy maybe on the twist. Chest down, and definitely 1 foot over the line, which will be an additional deduction.
Andair, 13-166.
You see that 7.3 execution out of a 10. He was doing a great job, but you have to hit handstands on non-release skills, and he didn't.
So that number in the 14.533, nearly 56.832 overall. And the man who is battling and right in the mix, Artur Delaloyan from Russia, getting ready on ball. Sixth. Going into this rotation.
He'll also do that triple twisting post-flight skill.
2018.
Oh, he's capable of doing a handspring double pike. That's what he does for his second vault, and that is what he's doing. Oh, my! Yikes!
I'm pretty sure he had that stick, almost just doubted himself a little bit.
Wow.
That was so good.
Oh, we are not seeing anybody trembling.
I mean, this, what a fun rotation.
Yeah, it's the whole event, all of the main players. Look at this, so much more difficult because he keeps his legs straight. And like you said, Nasia, why didn't he stick this? Look at it's perfect. Oh.
I think he surprised himself a little
bit,
to be honest.
It seemed like it, right?
This should be a ginormous score because look at his body position on the landing. That is so critical.
That is perfect landing position right there.
If the judges don't think so, well, then they're wrong.
Well,
I
would have gone higher.
I would have gone a tenth higher as well.
look at us being critical on a 9-5 execution.
And if you are scoring at home, it's the second ginormous up this year. All right, Sam Mikulic, the last to go here on vault, and obviously needs a big number as well.
He does need a big number, but you see right there that 5.2, all of the main contenders coming into vault, they were all doing 5.6 vaults, so 15.6 maximum. Sam's capable of doing that vault, hasn't done it since he tore his Achilles. He'll do the same type of vault we saw from Yule, a 2.5, but he can do it great.
Okay.
Where are all those mistakes under pressure that we expected to see?
Yeah, you know what? Been saying it for about a decade.
Well, I'm not talking about him. I'm talking about overall in the event.
No, absolutely. You're right. I'm very surprised. But remember, they still got to do high bar.
Tim doesn't like to be wrong.
No.
No, he'll be happy to be wrong with this.
Yes, I will. Really nicely done. Fights for that landing. I'll tell you what, that stick on this vault, when you're comparing it to the other gymnast, he's starting 0.4 of a point lower, but that right there, and a very good body position also on the landing as well.
He was in third place heading into this rotation. So we've seen 15 plus on the vault, 14.6 from Mikulic.
He just couldn't lose too much ground there.
Yeah. Oleg Vernayev. Can you call him the surprise leader after three rotations?
Absolutely. Absolutely. He qualified in the 18th spot. But he knew he was going to qualify. There was no question about that. And certainly, I think, was maybe saving himself. But this is Oleg's Achilles heel. The high bar really bothers his shoulder. A little bit of bent arms on that giant, which will be a deduction. But definitely much better. Oh, boy. And that right there, a whole half a point for not going over the bar. And right there once again.
Short on that handstand, leg separation, very short there.
Wow, this is a shame because it has been a magical round for Oleg, coming back from very serious injuries.
Oh man. Heartbreak for those fans and for Vernayev. Yule Moldauer, by the way, was just prior to that on high bar 13.033. You knew that was going to be tough, but Oleg Vernayev and holding the shoulder after that routine on high bar.
And, you know, as I said, rings and high bar are really difficult, and it's because he has to do all of these elements where his arms don't just go over his head, but past his head into like an arched shoulder position, and it is excruciating when you've got shoulder problems.
Kazuma Kaya, this is short time ago. Parallel bars. That's a huge hit for Vernayev.
And once again, I just hope that he hasn't rushed it too much.
Kaya in seventh going into this fourth rotation.
It has been a very long time since a Japanese person has not been on the podium for the all-around, both at Worlds and the Olympic Games. Kohei had to drop out in 2017.
I was going to say, when you have the greatest of all time,
yes,
that's a pretty good run.
But Kenzo Shirai was able to sneak in there and get a medal in Montreal last year. It's a pretty deep field, though. I'll tell you, with the two Russians, the two Chinese, Sam Mikulic, gonna be hard to break in there. Was good. Very good. Nice straddle front 1 1/4. You see those arms are got a, some kind of a bandage on them. Not a bandage, some neoprene. When they slam their arms on the bar, it hurts.
So 14-7-6-6, and right now at least in fifth place for Kazuma Kaya. Over Hagi on high bar. This also a short time ago taking place.
I've said this before, but this is one of my favorite routines in all of gymnastics. Gorgeous height. Watch this combo right here. Right to the handstand and, oh, spectacular. It's a little bit old school, but in my opinion, a lot harder than even some of these main releases that he'll also do.
James Hall of Great Britain, one great performance after another.
Parallel nice handstand position. And like I said, with him on parallel bars, he just has such a beautiful look.
5.6 difficulty for all three twists.
This is fabulous so far. Full twisting, double, oh! That would have been the icing on the cake, but wow, what a gorgeous set.
Didn't look at the end like he had the fight to hit. I mean, it looked like he had it.
And I have no idea where they got
seven?
That score.
Okay, even though it's a 7-9, but a 7 execution. That, I mean.
I just have no idea. That is crazy. I'm sorry. That is way, way too harsh.
Hagi in 16th after the third rotation, and then that number lower than expected.
Oh.
As we take you back to James Hall, once again, on parallel bars.
Was in 10th position after the third rotation. Some of these elements where he's doing these flipping elements, he's not getting enough open of his body. Even though they look error-free, when the judges are coming up with 2 points, like on that last routine, and I didn't see a point.
Yeah, it's to be honest, a little ridiculous.
They really need to do something about that, in my opinion, and I'm not alone in that. A nice job. You know, once again, it's going to be hard for a gymnast like James to break into that upper echelon. He's got nice gymnastics. He's very accomplished, but not quite at the level of the very top at this point.
So seventh place right now after the 14-5 for James Hall. Over the floor from Armenia, Artur Davtian. 14th place after three rotations.
That was a pretty good fight on that right there because I thought he was a little bit over on his first layout and had to make that double flip around and did so well. Nicely done. He's really close to the edge, but I don't see a sign that he stepped out. So on a floor exercise routine, you need to do all the acrobatic stuff that you see constantly, but you also need to do something like that. It's a requirement group, gives you an additional 0.5 of a point. A lot of gymnasts accomplish it with a press to a handstand, or they do a circling motion like you see on the pommel horse. Beautiful dismount. It's funny to me, I watch this guy, his run, it almost looks, it looks a little like a little kid because when they're tumbling, they don't know exactly how many steps they're going to take, and they just kind of run, and that he has that look, as you see right here, a little bit on that, but definitely on the dismount. You know, when you get a little bit more advanced, every single thing you do is choreographed. You know you're going to take four steps or maybe even five, and he just didn't look to me, especially on his dismount. See if we get a chance to see it again. Here is that required element. It's a triple Russian three times around. Nope. Of course, they don't show the run, but they did show that, the perfect stuck landing.
By the way, give you the number quickly as we went to break. Yul Moldauer on high bar, 13.033. And right now, at least, he's in 11th. 13.7 downtown from Armenia as we continue here. The men's all around, been a good one so far. Two rotations left. Here are the current standings from China. Zhao Rutong trying to defend his title in the all-around. Galiloyan moves up from Russia. Nikita Nagorny also from Russia, rounding out the top three. So Sam Mikulic, who was there, now currently in fourth. Yul Moldauer currently in 11th. But look at how close it is. I mean, you've got, for the top group at least, parallel bars and high bar, and it could come down, probably will come down to one small mistake.
And I'll tell you what, if you're Sam Mikulic sitting in fourth place, there is no problem right now. If he does what he's capable on these next two events, unquestionably, he's going to get a medal and probably at least a silver.
Bold statement.
Bill, I was just about to say that, but, and we talk about this over and over again, but this really is when every single tenth of a point matters. You know, you think like, oh, I'll take a step here. I'll move my arm here. It truly can come down to this. We saw this in the men's team finals where it was absolutely insane, less than a tenth of a point. This is where you really have to look into detail right now.
Oleg Granayev, by the way, who was in the lead heading into that last rotation, the problems on high bar all the way down to ninth place right now. And that's how big one routine can be. Simone Biles, Morgan Hurd, who'll lead the way for the U.S. women tomorrow in the all-around.
Cheering on Team USA, Sam and Yul, of course.
Yeah, really nice to see them here and having the opportunity. You know, under the old regime, that would not have been possible.
We were not allowed.
No.
Back in our hotel room.
What would your routine, so to speak, be like?
Literally, gym to the cafeteria or whatever, wherever the meals were, and right back to your room.
Uh-huh. You know, you sit here and you observe, having been through both of you guys, if you are a Sam Mikulic on the verge now with two routines left, two apparatus left, you're hopefully not thinking about how it's going to come down perhaps to one small mistake.
Well, you know, and I think what we have talked about even off the air is we now know, and hopefully he knows, that he belongs here. This isn't a surprise for him to be this close to the top, this close to the podium, being able to really, as you said, Tim, he could come away with a silver medal if he can just do two clean routines. So he is capable. He just needs to believe that and not look at the standings and think, oh my gosh, look at this opportunity or this chance that, you know, I possibly have.
Well, he could get a gold medal. But what I'm saying is if all of the people that are competing do what they're capable of doing, Sam's going to move ahead.
Of course, we're going to see James Hall kick things off here on the high bar from Great Britain. Currently in seventh place going into rotation number five, which is underway.
He's about a point back from medal territory. But a lot to be proud of. Very successful competition for him. Great Britain, of course, finished right behind the U.S. in fifth spot in the team competition. And that right there, definitely a big deduction, and they have been pretty tight on high bar. That one, excellent. Those skills have to finish right in a handstand. You can lose up to a half a point on them if they don't. Very solid, absolutely very solid. He's a pretty clean gymnast overall. But you see, it's not as clean as you're gonna see from some of the gymnasts in this last round, who will do that exact movement, which is a cassina, named after the great Italian Olympic champion on high bar.
So, over to parallel bars, and this top group, Zhao Rotong, will be the first man up. And in the lead, 58.032, the number for him, but less than a point, obviously, that lead right now.
It almost looks like the top group is thriving because of the competition at this point in time. Nobody is faltering, and it's almost empowering them to say, I can't even have the smallest of errors, because thus far for the top group, this is the most error-free I can remember in a long, long time.
And they'll lead less than 0.2 of a point at the moment.
And that's the kind of competition you have where, you know, the top 6 to 8 athletes all have the best competition.
And what he does so well, like I said, is he opens up his body on some of those release skills, doesn't stay in a tucked position.
On the board, representing Switzerland, Oliver Hagen.
Very nice routine thus far. Double pike, small little shuffle to the side, but really good. Scored a 15 in the qualifying. He was 8th place. Look at the kick out of his legs right there. You don't see that with many athletes. And once again, he'll do it again. Tell you what, it's really hard to repeat, too, you know? I mean, that's something else.
Is that routine in the 15 range?
Yeah, it is. It absolutely is. But once again, I think Sam is a little cleaner on parallel bars.
Sam McCulloch will be 5th to go on parallel bars in this rotation. Yeah, 15.333, so even better than he did in the qualifying.
And that is a big deal for him. Hopefully he's not thinking about what happened a couple days ago. Went to high bar and fell off on his first major release, and that put the gold medal for Team China in jeopardy. They eventually won that, but it was a very tight race.
So we'll keep it here on parallel bars. From Japan, Kenzo Shirai, currently in 8th place going into this 5th rotation.
And if you wonder, he always gives a yell as he raises his hand, and I asked him about that, and it's like, it's from the younger days in Japan, and he would basically be telling the judge that was watching, thank you for your attention to my routine. Mm. It's a form of respect, but that's a form of a deduction right there. Bent elbow, swing to a handstand. Gonna lose at least 0.3. And he's a phenomenal gymnast, there's no question, just off the charts on both floor and vaulting, the reigning world champion on those two events. But when everybody else that is capable of factoring in is great and error-free, it's a long road for Kenzo to be on that podium. Dismount, double front half, and a very nice routine, respectable, but we just saw better, and we're gonna see better down the road. You see, he just was off of the floor. You're not allowed to touch the ground at all. Some gymnasts, when they do those long swings, it's very hard for them, but you see little knee breaks and little legs apart as he's grasping. Very, very good, but not like we just saw from Zhao Rutang, or my guess what we'll see from someone like Nikita.
James Hall, high bar routine 13-6. So into second, but that's misleading right now.
Very misleading because the very top gymnasts have yet to go.
So we continue with our coverage here in the fifth rotation of six, the men's all-around final, and it is so close at the top. 13-8-6-6. Kenzo Shirai, Zhao Rutong was terrific to lead off this fifth rotation. Sun Wei will be next to go in sixth after four rotations.
But he's a fair amount out of the medal chances. Just needs to do his job, though. Beautiful. When he is on, he is as good as anybody, oftentimes better in the entire world. Dismount, double front half, and a great exercise.
China, as expected, awfully good here in the all-around, as they were in the team final, which they won. It was close, but just over Russia.
Less than 0.05 of a point.
Yeah.
There isn't even a deduction.
How do you sleep at night?
0.05 of a point. Yeah, a judge can't take a 0.05 of a point deduction.
Yeah, that's. I don't know if there's anything worse. I've been in a similar situation.
Well, you talk all the time about how a silver medal is not a loss or a failure, but in that moment, you got to feel like it is.
You definitely have thoughts like that just because you're so close. Again, don't get me wrong. A silver is an amazing accomplishment. But when you go back to the competition, you are replaying every single routine, every single step, every single movement, thinking, what if, what could I have done?
Nastia, not everyone can win the gold like you.
Tim, I know. I won the silver at a world championships in the all-around by .001. I remember the feeling.
And how close will it be at the end of today for the top couple?
What a competition.
It really has been just amazing.
Fantastic.
The differing reactions depending on who you're cheering for there.
Well, you just saw that was Dennis McIntyre, who is the head of the men's side for USA Gymnastics. And he doesn't really like seeing stuck landings from anybody not wearing red, white, and blue today.
It wasn't a smile.
No.
Not a happy face. Artur Delaloyan from Russia will be up next on parallel bars.
And he is the one that caused all the misery, and it was on this routine in the team finals. He missed this skill.
Not today.
Perfect.
And second going into rotation number five.
But he is great on parallel bars. That's why it was shocking to see him fall. Here's the beautiful, great height on that. He self-corrected himself a while back, was frustrated that he was never near the very top, and said, I'm not focused, I'm not determined enough, I'm not making the sacrifices to hang with these guys that I'm training with every day. Made a change, and what a difference, and what a routine Oh,
just one after another.
It is unbelievable. There has never been an all-around final like this. I cannot believe how great everybody's been.
Great momentum coming in here for Dalaloyan. Three titles at the European Championships here in 2018, but this is a different level.
And that was the skill, as I said, that knocked Team Russia off the top spot, gave them a silver in the team competition, but not today. Look at this. He is spotting that ground. Folks, that is not that easy to do. First of all, you're exhausted at the end of a routine like that.
What part of you thinks that we think that looks easy?
Oh, my. Tell you what, this is fun, you know, as a huge fan of the sport.
Look at that number two, 15-5-6-6 for Dalaloyan into first place.
Wow.
So Zha Rutong, who had the lead going into this rotation, now is in second. And Soon Wei rounds out the top three.
Parallel bar scores have been higher today, though. Sam, for example, had a 15.033 in the qualifying. A couple tenths lower than that in the team championships.
So Sam Mikulik in fourth place going into this rotation, but less than a tenth of a point out. It is so close.
He actually had one small mistake in the team final, and it came right here, kind of flubbed his hand placement. Perfect today. Locked arms, perfectly done. Watch this combo, awesome. And here's his time to fly. One of my favorite routines in all of gymnastics, the way Sam does this. He's got game today.
Wow.
One of the best in the world and proving it today. Morgan Hurd loves it.
His coach, Andrei Stepchenko, very happy with that.
One, two, go.
Guys, think about it, too. You're watching gymnast after gymnast at the highest level come through under pressure, then you got to follow them.
You know, honestly, I think it's even more pressure when you see everybody ahead of you hit as well as they have. That was just spectacular.
And the amount of that happening today for the top guys rocking those landings.
Simone. That's great. So how big will the number be for Mikulik now?
Well, it's gonna be a 15. There should be no question about that. The way they've been going, I would say it should be 15-2 range-ish. Maybe even, I don't know, it's possible a little more.
Dalaloyan the leader, 15-4-4-1 for Mikulik.
Wow.
And into third place. So ahead of Soon Wei from China, right behind Zha Rutong, the reigning champ, and Artur Dalaloyan from Russia is the leader right now. So for those names, one rotation left, and it's the high bar.
We got a shot of the King Kohei in the audience. And initially, I didn't know if he was here. Got to be hard for him to watch.
Final man on parallel bars, Nikita Nagorny from Russia. And he was ahead of Mikulik in third going into this rotation.
But Sam put up a very big number. Really tricky. Deals with that well. Oh boy. Wow, that was a great save. He was off on that skill, able to hold on. And another, that opens the door definitely.
Oh.
And so does that.
Can't bear to watch.
Dmitry Lankin, his teammate.
He knows it.
Yeah.
And what we say, one small mistake, and that's going to be the difference here coming down the stretch.
When the competition is this tight and all of the top athletes are hitting routine after routine, there is no room for errors like this.
Fought it. Couldn't. Kenzo Shirai, they have changed the score 14-6-6. And currently in 16th place.
What? We've seen that dismount from so many athletes, that double front, half turnout.
Oh, 14-8-6-6, yep. And so they switch places. He's down in fourth place, and he's behind Sam Mikulik, who is in the medal position going into his last routine.
And just so you know, Sam is much better on high bar than Nikita Nagorny.
Kazuma Kaya now, last man to go on high bar from Japan. In fifth place after four rotations.
Has not brought in a big number on high bar thus far, only a 13.3 from the qualifying, and that will not allow you to hang with the upper crew currently. Nice element. This has got to go to a handstand, and right there, it's a built-in deduction for just about everyone. Those German Giants, they're awesome, but they're really hard to get out of it without incurring penalties. Double-double, great landing. Really nice job for him. Just that one very visible error, missing that handstand position. And also this routine doesn't have the same start value that we'll see from the top group.
That number for his teammate a moment ago, Kenzo Shirai, was wrong on the graphic. He's in sixth, not 16th, as you take another look in slow-mo here.
A lot of the top gymnasts will do a skill like that, and then they'll connect it right away into another release. That, of course, makes it more difficult and gives you extra points.
Close up look at chalk flying.
Oh, my goodness. So you can't catch with bent arms on a release. But this was awesome. Not even a doubt.
Well, maybe a little doubt. But he held it.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, he is happy.
13.733.
Yeah, big improvement.
Yeah, absolutely. So in the sixth, as they close out rotation number five, and how close this is. What some drama here as we come down the stretch,
this
huh?
This is going to be fun.
One more rotation left, and the top names will be on high bar as we continue with the men's all-around. Sam Mikulik trying to win his first individual medal at the World Championships. Ja Rutung trying to repeat the last man to do that, the great Kohei Uchimura, who did it a number of times. Lastly, in 2015, but the man who leads the way, Artur Dalaloyan from Russia. Less than a tenth of a point separating the top two. That switched after rotation number five. Rutong had the lead, doesn't anymore. Dalaloyan from Russia. And Sam Mikulic now up to third. And the lead over Nikita Nagorny, who made the mistakes on the last, on the parallel bars, significant enough that if Sam Mikulic does his job?
Well, if Sam Mikulic does what he has done either day so far at the World Championships, and the other guys that are at the top don't, that they do exactly what they did, Sam Mikulic is the world all-around champion, and he has been waiting for that for so long.
Can we give away a secret? What did he say in break?
That he's
going to
win.
Yes, he did. So
no
on the verge, perhaps, of doing something he has yet to do in his career with all the success that he has had, and it comes down to one last rotation.
My hands are starting to sweat a little bit.
I was just about to say, all the expectations that you could have had for this men's all-around, they're surpassed.
It has been an absolutely amazing competition from start to finish in this rotation. This is the kind of competition you want. This is the type of competition that you want to win when everybody is at their absolute best. Sure, it's a win is a win. If someone has a mistake and you're still able to come out on top, that's incredible. But this is the best kind of competition.
Yeah, you know, I mean, of the top guys, Nikita Nagorny, he had a little bit of a problem on parallel bars. Not a major mistake, and that dropped him all the way to fourth.
Yul Moldauer, the other American here in the men's all-around final, rounding out the top 10. So he goes into this last rotation in 10th, and he will be on the pommel horse. Nagorny done with the warm-up here. And moments away from starting to see, as you look at the numbers for Dalaloyan throughout the event, and the total 73.432, and Rotung 73.365. That's how close the top two are.
Gonna say it again, though. Sam Mikulic yesterday had a 14.5 on high bar in the team finals. Zhao Rotung, in qualifying, well, actually, in the team final, scored a 12.6 with that fall. He is capable. He has scored low 14s earlier on, but.
First up of this group, on high bar, Kenzo Shirai from Japan, who comes in seventh into the final rotation.
Hi, and thank you for your attention. Love it. Has some big releases as well. First one comes up right here. He'll do this with legs straight. Gorgeous. And now he does a somewhat unorthodox for nowadays release. Front flip with a full twist. Is sometimes challenging for Kenzo. Does only a Kovacs. He's capable of doing it with a full twist.
Oh.
Very nice.
What a start.
Wow.
Way to set the tone.
Not of approval.
Just channel those vibes.
Yep. Shirai, who's an 8-time medalist at the World Championships. It's kind of the way the event started and has held throughout.
Gorgeous release. It's a Kovacs done in the pike position.
All rings from Turkey, Ferhat Alican.
Big no matter where he does these twisting skills, it's like he just knows exactly where he is, whether it's on the floor exercise, the vault, the high bar, just so perfect.
If you're sitting there and you're Sam McCooley, take me back. Would you be watching every part of every
team? You know, I hated watching, but I think every athlete is so different. I don't know about you, Tim.
I didn't watch too much. I remember in the Olympics when I was competing, I decided to sneak a peek, and I looked over and saw a great vault, and the guy got a 10, and I was like, don't do that again.
I think in the team competition, it's very different. You know, yeah. When you're competing with your teammates, obviously watching, cheering them on, supporting them, but when it comes down to the last event, I definitely wasn't watching.
An even 14 for Kenzo Shirai, and a wide smile.
Attack move, kid, let's get it!
McCulloch will be fourth to go on high bar. Not only watching, but cheering.
Yeah, cheering on Yule. Yeah. Exactly.
Probably across the arena.
Yeah, it is absolutely on the other side of the arena. I always found, though, that being able to do a really loud scream like that helped.
You've carried it over to your TV days.
Gorgeous. Well. Like I said earlier, he does those combinations, but that right there, 3/10 off minimum for not coming close to the handstand position. Personally, I'm really glad to see him have such a good championship and really look like one of the top guys in the world, because he's been it for a long time but just hasn't had the performances.
They're watching. So Soon Wei, with the completion of that, started this final rotation in fifth.
So hard to connect that release skill where he keeps his body completely straight. Everything was awesome except for that right there. Double twisting, double somersault. Like I said, one of the best lines in all of gymnastics, not just nowadays, but in the history of the sport, my humble opinion.
While that was taking place, a bit of a struggle for Yul Moldauer over on Pommel Horse. Get you that number as soon as we get it. So next up on a high bar, this top group, Artur Dalaloyan, who is the leader going into this final rotation.
In the qualifying round, he got a 14.166. And just to compare that to Sam, he got a 14.566.
14.266 for Soon Wei. Trying to move up from that fifth spot. So the 22-year-old from Russia and the leader at the moment, Artur Dalaloyan, about to go.
Well, a lot of people talk about redemption. And he knows it, and his teammates know it. They don't hold him at fault, but he was the reason Russia did not win that team gold medal with his error on parallel bars. As you can see, he's tremendous. Really nicely done. Let's see about the handstand. Great. Nice elbows straight on those giants, sometimes a problem. Another handstand element right here.
Perfect.
Genuine smile for Dalaloyan.
Well, he's going to get a medal.
What will it be? The leader, the man in second watching, Sam Mikulic, who's in third, next to go. And by the way, Yule Moldauer, in that struggle on pommel horse, 12.2 the number for Yule.
Beautiful release skill. Just kind of hold your breath when you're doing that. He's such a tremendous athlete. Physically, so strong, so quick. But this is what has been so key for the top group today. The landings have been off the charts. And that puts him in the charts for sure. Don't think there's a way he won't win a medal here today.
May have had that smile on his face before he even hit the floor. Mikulec and then Nikita Nagorny and Zhao Rontong from China, the last three to go on high bar. As we wait for that number, there it is, 14.166.
And that is surprising to me. The way they have been judging, that's a little lower than I thought they were going to be.
But the same exact score that he got in the qualifying round.
Yeah, absolutely the same. So now it's his turn. Sam Mikulec, the 26-year-old, five-time U.S. champ.
Sometimes you say to your athletes, think. And then sometimes you say, don't think. And I would say, don't think, just go, Sam. Big release, nice. He's got one more, this one in tuck. Mm. Oh my goodness! That was great. Do this in combination.
Oh.
And unbelievably, he has been phenomenal on high bar, both the qualifying and then the highest score of any gymnast in the team final. Just a dismount, but I don't know how much it's going to matter at this point.
Disbelief. Deloyan with the lead. Mikulec, who has been in this position before. 2013, with one rotation left in a position, man.
Yeah, he was in third.
Position to medal. And absolutely spectacular up until that point.
That was very good. And this one, don't quite know what he did right here. I don't.
You know, sometimes, and of course I've never done the men's high bar, but on release moves, even on the women's side, when you're a little nervous, you want to come a little bit closer to the bar.
No, absolutely, but I, you know, it wasn't, yeah, he was a little bit close, but he did that giant and he broke his shoulder angle, you know, about 90 degrees, Colin Van Wicklin, his training partner at the USOTC for the past few months, looking on in disbelief. Well, that does it for sure. Deloyan gonna get a medal. I would say it's just gold or silver. The only person who has a shot to do anything about that is Zhao Rutong.
Nagorny. Zhao's still to come. Yeah. And how damaging will this number be?
Well, it's, you know, there were spectacular aspects of the routine, but right there, that is a huge deduction.
Saw the reaction right away from Nagorny.
Yeah, and that gave life to Nagorny for sure.
who is in fourth going into the final rotation.
Now, Sam's not going to get a medal at this point.
So here it is. Wow. 12-3-6-6. And you wonder, been in this spot, didn't come through, and you wonder what's going through his. So close.
I actually think the score was way too low, though. I mean, there, obviously he had those two errors, but I don't know how they get that much with the way they've been judging.
So two more to go. And first, the man from Russia, Nikita Nagorny, who saw that all unfold and knows the door is wide open now. He was in fourth, right behind Mikulik.
Yeah, he just needs to stay on the bar, basically, and not have a major error. And he gets on the podium. That was really nice, yet very risky. Another one there, pretty good. One more release. Had a little bit of a struggle on that in the team championships. Barring disaster, on this dismount, Nikita Nagorny wins a world medal and overcomes Sam.
Russian teammate loves it. Nagorny thankful.
Got a 13.966 in the qualifying round.
And as an athlete, your career is defined by those moments, and this has been one of them for Sam Mikulik.
Such disappointment at the end for Team Russia in the qualifying, but not today.
Yeah, the team final came down to what, less than 0.05 of a point, and China wins it over Russia. But triumph in the end here. It's going to be a medal. We'll see what color it will be for Nikita Nagorny.
And you know, he did his job, no question about it, but he's not one of the strongest high bar workers in these finals. But
man,
so good to see. I just love, you know, as a
there it is, 13-9 into second place. So he does bump Sam Mikulik out with one man to go, Zhao Rotong. Rutong in second going into this last rotation, but there are the standings, and Mikulik down in fourth place.
So China went 1-2 at the World Championships in 2017. Russia now sitting 1-2. Zhao Rotong, the only man that can spoil the party. He's capable of greatness here. In the team finals, he came off on the first major release skill. Comes off right at the top, right here. Gorgeous. Some more releases right here. Nicely done. We'll do one more release, add a half turn to this at the end. That's the skill Sam struggled on, but he did it in combination. And once again, really just going for it. This is pretty darn good.
Wow. Little bit.
Oh.
Uncertainty right now. He would need 14.234 to win it. Zhao Rutong trying to back up what he did last year. He's the reigning world all-around champ, and we'll see how close it's going to be.
From what I have seen so far, the way the scores have gone, I think he's going to get it.
He had 14-4-3-3 in qualifying. He needs less than that here to win it.
I mean, there's no question it would have helped to have stuck the landing, but this so hard. Full twisting laid out to Kachev. And remember, just 2 days ago, came off the bar for China right at the end, and that was awesome. Just really going for that handstand. It's so risky on that skill. We saw Oleg Vernayev do that exact same skill and just be a little bit short and lose just tons of points for it. No question, those folks think he's got it. And
so Russia's gonna have two men on the podium, the men's all around, for the first time since the breakup of the Soviet Union. The number that you're looking for is 14.234. That's what Zhao Rutong needs to win.
But what an all around
14.233. Are you kidding me?
A tie.
That is exactly the number that makes it a tie.
Oh,
they have the same
gosh.
Total number, 87.598. Zhao Rutong and Artur Dalaloyan.
Wow.
My gosh.
I know all about the tie-breaking rule. Not a fan.
Is she, Beijing on bars?
On bars, we tiebreaker for
you.
First.
Yep. It's brutal. Absolutely brutal. I don't think they should do it either.
I don't.
They drop your lowest score, and it's Artur Dalaloyan who is going to win the world title in the all-around.
Talk about redemption.
Oh, my goodness.
From the team finals, they were so, so close to winning that gold medal as a team. Today, he comes away as the world all-around champion.
Dalaloyan, the gold. Zhao Rutong, oh, so close to going back-to-back, will win the silver. And Nikita Nagorny from Russia will stand on the podium as the bronze medalist.
Wow.
You know, it takes a moment to figure out the number because you look at it and you don't believe it.
Yeah. Well, I didn't believe it when I saw it, actually.
Look at the difference. 0.000.
You know, I don't agree with this. I think if you have the same exact score, both people should win the gold medal.
I'm in 100% agreement with you on
that's
that.
The way it used to be.
Yep.
My dad won a gold medal at the Olympic Games. It was a tie. They were both awarded a gold medal. Don't agree with the rule change.
Been in effect for quite a while.
Yep.
As you know, not a recent change.
I agree, but still.
We said it was going to be a close. We had no idea. Dalaloyan wins it. Man. So two men on the podium from Russia. Nikita Nagorny, the bronze medal at the World Gymnastics Championships. The men's all around, what a finish. I mean, little did we know. The top names were absolutely spectacular throughout. It comes down to a tie. It's broken. Zhao Rutong, who won it last year, ends up with the silver medal. And it's Artur Dalaloyan.
Yeah, he ends up with the silver, but he won too, in my opinion.
Absolutely.
Dalaloyan, the first Russian man to win the world all-around title since 1999. And again, they drop that lowest score. Take the five highest apparatus scores. That's how the tie is broken, that moment when he realizes it.
And that's redemption too. Remember, folks, he was the reason Russia finished in second place in the team. He fell off parallel bars.
So a couple of days ago, it's China barely beating Russia for the team gold. And this time around, it's a man from Russia with the win, as close as it possibly can get. Nalaloyan, the gold. Rutong, the silver. And Nagorny, the bronze. And Soonwei over Sam Mikulic, who again, it comes down to that final rotation in a position to win a medal in bronze medal position and has the mistakes on the high bar.
Yeah, not just to win a bronze. In my opinion, he could have been right at the top of the scoreboard there. You know, I mean, Dalalonian certainly put up a big number, as did, you know, Xiao Rotong. But, yeah, it, I'm sure devastating for Sam, and back to the drawing board.
His whole season, his whole outlook right now, his goals surrounding the international championships and coming up short. Yul Moldauer, by the way, finishes up in 12th. Pommel horse that last rotation, some problems on that. So outside the top 10 for Yul. So the men's event in the books, I don't think there's going to be as much drama with the women's.
Yeah, I don't
absolutely
think so.
Absolutely not. There will not be as close of a finish to Simone Biles, who, if all goes according to plan, will win the all-around tomorrow by a huge, huge margin.
Well, you saw that Simone was giving a piggyback ride to Morgan. Simone could win tomorrow with Morgan on her back.
Morgan heard who's the reigning all-around champ, but Simone Biles in the team finals, which the U.S. won going away.
And, you know, that was a quote-unquote easier vault for her. Still absolutely incredible, capable of doing a more difficult vault. Bars used to be her toughest event. Not anymore. Has qualified into all of the individual apparatus finals. Absolutely incredible.
Yeah, she's first on four of them. The all-around, on floor, on balance beam.
And she showed, you know, some signs of nerves yesterday, especially right here on the balance beam. Was off on that skill a little bit. But this is where her biggest mistake of the day came. Put her hand down, similar to what we saw at the Olympic Games in Rio just a few years ago.
And incredibly difficult and super powerful, but bounded out of bounds. Double-double at the end. She's unreal, though.
Had that look of surprise on her own face when she pounded out of bounds. Hugs all around from the U.S. teammates, and Morgan Hurd also a big part of it. You mentioned in the qualifying setting the table and the lead up, but certainly in athlete, I mean, she won this thing last year, the all around.
Oh, absolutely. She is, I would say, certainly a podium finisher without doubt, and very well could be second once again. I mean, anything can happen. Simone could, you know, have another problem with the kidney stone. It could get more inflamed. You never know. But I'll tell you, Morgan Hurd was a rock for the USA from start to finish.
And truly better than she was last year when she won the world all-around title, stepped out of bounds right there. Not a huge mistake, but was just such a phenomenal performance in the team finals.
Well,
that they had
her qualifying score was higher than the one which took her to the all-around win last year.
Crazy.
And the team win for the U.S., the women's event, the largest margin of victory under the current scoring system at the World Championships or the Olympics. They won by the 8.766 points.
And do you know what's sickening about that? They were nowhere near as good as they can be.
That's a bit scary.
Very scary.
So, Simone Biles and Morgan Hurd, the two top numbers. Look at that number from Simone Biles. I mean, really.
It's just incredible.
And the kidney stone, dealing with that and just off the charts. But those names, including Mai Murakami, big name from Japan that we will see in the women's all-around, that is tomorrow. Well, they better be good. They better be impressive if they're going to back up what the men did today, because it was outstanding, one of the best that you're ever going to see. And it's Artur Dalaloyan from Russia, who in the end ends up with the same number as Xiao Rutong, but wins the gold medal, as we come back to wrap things up in a moment. It is the reality of competition at this level, but those mistakes
Tell the tale for Sam Mikulic. So close again, and every bit of his preparation, his practice, everything he thinks about throughout all the hard work in the year. It's about meddling at the World Championships or the Olympics, and he comes up just short once again.
He'll have four more chances, though.
Yep.
And his best chance, ironically, comes on high bar. He was ranked second, won the second day of competition at Pipe.
Oh, ironic in some way, huh? Nagorny, the bronze medal, was outside the top three going into that last rotation. What are you thinking if you're Xiao Rutong?
Tiebreakers should not exist, is basically what I'm thinking.
You know, 2016 was such a battle between Kohei Uchimura and Oleg Vernayev. It was so close. But I have to say that this all-around final is the most amazing one that I've ever seen. The level of difficulty that was done, and for this young man to come out on top, especially after basically letting Team Russia down, falling on the parallel bars, you know, in the competition before in the team finals, but what a job he did today, start to finish.
First all-around win for Russian man since 1999 at the World Championships. There he is, Artur Dalaloyan. Yeah, from start to finish, I mean, that group started on floor, and it was one impressive routine after another, and then it just continued throughout the entire event.
Yeah, really the only one that didn't get it done from that group that was looking so spectacular was Sam.
And all those opportunities he still has, you wonder mentally what effect this has to have it in your grasp again.
I can't even guess.
The national anthem of the Russian Federation.
So, we continue with our coverage tomorrow. As you saw, Simone Biles, Morgan Hurd, and the women for the all-around final Olympic Channel. And you can also check that out, NBCSN, and Apparatus Finals on Olympic Channel and SN as well, 10 o'clock p.m. on Friday. Throughout the week, our coverage here at the 48th edition of the World Gymnastics Championships. Again tomorrow, Simone Biles, Morgan Hurd. Simone, the three-time world champ, going for a record fourth title, live at 9 a.m. Eastern on Olympic Channel, home of Team USA. How about this men's all-around? Was it good enough for you?
If it wasn't, I don't get you.
Might be something wrong. See you tomorrow, everybody. For Tim Daggett and Nastia Lukin, I'm Terry Gannon. So long.
See the biggest stars in figure skating each week on your home for the ISU Grand Prix. The Olympic Channel, home of Team USA.